Okay, let me give you 5 more color grading tips, tricks, and hacks in DaVinci Resolve to make your color grades look better or just to make your color grading easier and faster. Here we go. So, I see this question popping up a lot in the comments, or actually it's always a variation on the same question. For example, how do I copy-paste color grades to other clips? Or how do I apply the same color grade to all the clips on my timeline? And I've already shown you one of my favorite techniques, which is color grading in an adjustment clip, and then you can drag that adjustment clip over all the clips you want to have the same color grade. I've also shown you how to create a power grade, which allows you to save your entire node structure that you can then use in all your projects. But of course, there's another option to easily color grade all the clips on your timeline at the same time. But it's kind of hidden, and that's also why I've actually created a habit myself of not using it, because I only found out about it a year after I started using Resolve. But it's actually super useful. So if you select a clip in your timeline and then go to the color page and start color grading, you're basically grading that one clip. But up here, if you click on that second dot here, or set this to timeline, you switch to timeline nodes. And if I add a node here and make some changes, do some color grading, well, then it will affect all the clips on the timeline. And so you can, for example, use that as your base color grade or your base corrections, and then switch to clip nodes and there make adjustments to individual clips. Super useful. Next is another question that I see a lot in the comments. And yeah, so the thing is, a lot of times I actually prefer to answer your questions in a video instead of in the comments because it's too difficult to explain everything in the comments. But that also means that sometimes you'll have to wait for a few weeks or months for me to answer your question. I'm sorry about that, but I always try to answer your questions, so just have some patience. Anyway, so the qualifier tool is super powerful and I use it all the time, for example, to correct skin tones. You can easily make a selection of the skin by just clicking on it and then hit Shift plus H to show the gray mask, your selection. And then fine-tune the selection down here. Soften it, you know, you can do all the adjustments here. So it's super powerful, but because you're selecting colors and tones, if there's something in the background, for example, that has the same or a similar color, it will be included in the selection, and maybe you don't want that. Well, it's super easy to fix. So this is my selection, and let's say I can't fine-tune it anymore. The lightning sign in the background is now included. But what if I want just my face? Well, go to Windows and just add a window. I'll add a circular one now. And see, now everything outside that window won't be included in the selection. Simple. And you can also do it the other way around, by the way. First create a window and then use the qualifier to select your tones within that window. So the qualifier tool, super powerful. Windows, super powerful, but combining them, what's better than super? What's more than super? Ultra? Ultra powerful. So this one's for beginners specifically, but I'm also gonna show you something that not a lot of people know, I think. I'm building up tension here. Maybe that's not a good idea because then disappointments might be imminent. Whoa. No, disappointment might be imminent. Disappointment imminent. Reminds me of that children's book. How was it? The Emony? No. The anemone is not the emony. No! The anemone is not the emony. The anemone, no. The anemone is not the enemy. There we go. Okay, anyway, so if you're a Resolve color grading beginner, where do you start? Well, in my opinion, one of the first things you should learn and try to master is these wheels, the color wheels. These are so powerful and versatile, it's ridiculous. If you combine these wheels with the qualifier and the windows, like I showed you, you can already do so much and get great results. I usually use these wheels to balance my image, do some color correction, but you can actually start color grading your image with them. I'm just gonna show you something super simple now, color correction. If your image looks too warm, for example, you could use the temperature slider to fix that, but you can also use the wheels. Just use gamma, and it just gives you a lot more control. Now, simply put, gamma affects the midtones, lift affects the shadows, and gain the highlights, and offset the entire image. but there is overlap. And that's actually the main difference between the primaries and those other wheels, the log wheels, midtones, highlights, and shadows. So the primaries are more balanced than the log wheels, in a way. And I can show you. When I increase lift here, for example, in the color wheels, like that, well, I can do exactly the same in the curves, exactly the same. If I go to the curves, and then, well, do you know the curves? So down here are the shadows, then here are the midtones, and up here the highlights. Now, if I raise the shadows down here, like this, this does exactly the same as increasing lift. And as you can see, it raises the shadows, but also the midtones, which are in the middle of that diagonal line, but in a lesser amount, and even the highlights get affected, but even less than the midtones. So this is a visual representation of the range of the lift wheel, actually. Now, raising the shadows with the shadow wheel, like I said, is more focused on just the shadows. There's no overlap. And in the curves, raising the shadows with the shadows wheel would look something like this. So the shadows wheel does not affect the midtones and the highlights. It stops right here. And here's what it looks like for the gamma and midtones, for example. So I hope this makes the difference between the log wheels and the primaries a bit more clear. But in my opinion, the primaries are the ones you should learn first. Next is tracking windows. And I've already shown you this in other videos, but it seems like a lot of you have missed it. Or, well, a lot of you also think that it's super difficult, but it's not. It's really not. It's super simple. I can show you in 30 seconds. So let's say you made a window, but it's a moving shot. And for example, you want that window to follow a person's face. Well, just go to tracker, hit track, and that's it. The window will now follow the face. Or you can also use the point tracker down here instead of the cloud tracker. Then select this icon and then put that little cross, the plus icon, over the object you want to track. It could be part of a face, an eye, a nose, or an object. And then hit track and that's it. Again, the window will now follow that object. I mean, easy peasy, right? So color grading is not always about color. I mean, it's also about contrast, obviously, but that's not what I mean. What I mean is that sometimes making a part of an image brighter or darker makes it so much better than messing around with the colors or giving it an edgy color grade. And a lot of beginners forget that. They just want that teal and orange, and that's it. And so I use tracked windows all the time to, not change the light, but to help the light. It's okay to help the light, to make everything look a bit more dramatic, or maybe to help draw attention to a specific object or the subject. Here's a quick example. This scene looks okay, right? Well, it actually looks great. The lighting is interesting, but by adding a few windows and playing around with the wheels and the curves, and even saturation sometimes, you can make a scene look even better, more interesting. And this is something you can't do by just cranking up the contrast. So, for example, you can make some objects or parts get less attention so that the subject gets all the attention, or you can make the light pop even more. You see the difference here? Just by adding some windows and playing around with brightness. And that's it. This video will be a little bit longer than I expected, but oh well, now I can add a mid-roll ad and then buy a fat steak in the weekend with the revenue from that mid-roll ad. So thank you for that. Two fat steaks, two mid-roll ads, two fat steaks. Fat steak and a beer?